Please write down volumetric strain. So already we have discussed what is meant by volumetric strain. It is the ratio of change in volume to the original volume. Okay. And it has no unit. Volumetric strain is denoted by using epsilon V. So by mathematically epsilon V, which is equal to del V, that is change in volume upon V, that is original volume. Now we will see what is the relation between them by using Poisson's ratio. For that, please draw this figure. Okay, draw this figure, then we will continue. Okay, let me know after drawing. So I will continue. Okay, if your drawing is over, can I continue?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, now we have to see how to get this epsilon V or epsilon 1, 2, 3 formulas. Okay. So already we have discussed volumetric strain epsilon V, which is equal to del V upon V. Okay. So here one block is present. Okay. And on that block, number of forces are applied. P1, P2, P3. Okay. This is P1 force. This is P2 force. And this is P3 force. Also due to this P1 force, stress will be generated and strain will be generated. So here sigma 1 and epsilon 1 be present. Here P2, due to this force, stresses and strains are generated on that particular plane. So this stress and strain is present here. And due to this P3 force, stress and strain will be generated. So this stress and strains present on this portion. Now we have to see what is the combined effect of these all forces on that block. Okay, so we will consider combined effect. So when we are going to consider combined effect, at that time we have to see, or we have to find out the strain in particular plane 1. Suppose this is plane 1. Okay. Suppose this is plane 1. Suppose this is our plane 1. This is plane 1. This is plane 2. And this is plane 3. Now we will see what effect will be generated due to this all forces on this plane 1, 2 and 3. Okay, now we will consider sigma x, which is equal to sigma y, which is equal to sigma z, which is equal to sigma. That means it indicates stress along x axis, stress along y axis and stress along z axis, which is equal to sigma. So stress along x axis, which is equal to stress along y axis, which is equal to stress along z axis. So here sigma x, which is equal to sigma y, which is equal to sigma z, which is equal to stress, normal stress. This is our normal stress. Okay. Now, according to this, we have to find out strain along plane 1, strain along plane 2 and strain along plane 3. So here, I have written here epsilon 1 plus epsilon 2 plus epsilon 3. Now we will see one by one. Epsilon 1. Epsilon 1 which is equal to sigma 1 upon E minus mu into sigma 2 upon E minus mu into sigma 3 upon E. This is the formula for this strain generated in this plane 1. Now we will see how this formula comes. Okay, we will see how this formula comes. Already we know that. Okay, already we know that one relation. Okay, we have studied it Hooke's law. So Hooke's law states that stress is directly proportional to strain. Okay, stress is directly proportional to strain. And mu which is equal to, mu which is equal to lateral strain to the linear strain. Mu which is equal to lateral strain to the linear strain. Okay, now we will see, suppose this is part 2. Okay, this is part 2. So when we are going to learn part 2, at that time this P2 is an axial force. P2 is an axial force and this P1 we will consider as a longitudinal force. Okay, so one basic formula already we know that Poisson's ratio mu which is equal to lateral strain to the linear strain. Okay, lateral strain to the linear strain or lateral strain to the axial strain. Okay, so we are considering this P2 force. Apan kutla force consider karto hai P2. Manje to kya hota hai ta axis madun pass hote. So axial strain which is equal to epsilon 2. Okay, axial strain which is equal to epsilon 2 and lateral strain which is equal to epsilon 1. बघा ज्या वेळी आपण काय केलेलं आहे हा ब्लॉक कन्सिडर केलेला आहे त्याच्यात हा एक फोर्स जातोय ऍक्सिस मधून सो दिस इज एक्झियल अँड दिस इज लिनियर सॉरी लॅटरल दिस इज लॅटरल सो म्यू विच इज इक्वल टू मायनस लॅटरल अपॉन एक्झियल विच इज इक्वल टू एप्सिनॉल 1 डिवाइडेड बाय एप्सिनॉल 2 फ्रॉम दॅट वी विल गेट वन इक्वेशन ओके फ्रॉम दॅट वी विल गेट वन इक्वेशन एप्सिनॉल 2 into mu which is equal to epsilon 2 into mu which is equal to epsilon 1. Epsilon 2 into mu which is equal to epsilon 1. Okay, this relation we will get. Now we will see epsilon 1 which is equal to epsilon 1 which is equal to minus mu into. Now I have to write for this epsilon 2. Okay. Already we know that stress is directly proportional to the strain. That is Hooke's law. So stress is directly proportional to the strain. After that stress which is equal to E into epsilon. So epsilon which is equal to stress upon Young's modulus. Okay. This basic already we have studied it. So I have to write here epsilon 2 which is equal to sigma upon here E. Okay. लक्षात येते का हे बघा आपण ऑलरेडी हुक्स लॉ लर्न केलेला आहे सो हुक्स लॉ स्टेट्स दॅट स्ट्रेस इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्ट्रेन अँड स्ट्रेस इज डिनोटेड बाय सिग्मा अँड स्ट्रेन इज डिनोटेड बाय एप्सिलॉन व्हेन वी आर गोइंग टू रिमूव्ह दिस डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल साइन ऍट दॅट टाइम वन इलास्टिक कॉन्स्टंट इज देअर अँड दिस इज ई सो सिग्मा विच इज इक्वल टू ई इन टू एप्सिलॉन नाऊ वी हॅव टू राईट फॉर्म्युला इन टर्म्स ऑफ एप्सिलॉन दॅट इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ स्ट्रेन सो स्ट्रेन विच इज इक्वल टू epsilon which is equal to stress upon Young's modulus or modulus of elasticity sigma upon E. Now we have to write this equation as a epsilon 2. So mu into sigma 2 upon E. Mu into sigma 2 upon E. So this is the value of E1. So I have written here. Okay. Minus mu into sigma 2 upon E. लक्षात आलं का ही व्हॅल्यू कशावरून आली आहे तुमची सिग्मा टू अपॉन ई तर त्याच्यासाठी बेसिक फॉर दॅट म्यू विच इज इक्वल टू लॅटरल स्ट्रेन अपॉन लिनियर स्ट्रेन ऑर एक्झियल स्ट्रेन वी आर कन्सिडरिंग दिस पी टू ऍज अ एक्झियल ऍट दॅट टाइम दिस पी वन ऍज अ लॅटरल स्ट्रेन सो एप्सिनॉल 1 डिवायडेड बाय एप्सिनॉल 2 विच इज इक्वल टू म्यू सो म्यू इंटू एप्सिनॉल टू बघा एप्सिनॉल टू का होते म्यू कडे ट्रांसफर होते सो एप्सिनॉल टू इंटू म्यू विच इज इक्वल टू एप्सिनॉल वन हियर माइनस सो दिस माइनस गोइंग दिस डायरेक्शन सो एप्सिनॉल वन विच इज इक्वल टू माइनस म्यू इंटू एप्सिनॉल टू बट ऑलरेडी वी स्टडीड हुक्स लॉ इन हुक्स लॉ स्ट्रेस इज डायरेक्टली प्रपोर्शनल टू दी स्ट्रेस दैट इज स्ट्रेस सिग्मा विच इज इक्वल टू ई इंटू एप्सिनॉल फ्रॉम दैट we get this equation epsilon which is equal to stress upon Young's modulus so he I have written here sigma 2 upon e so from that this equation comes after that similarly if you are considering this p3 as a axial force and this p1 as a lateral force so automatically you will get minus mu into sigma 3 upon e so by applying this both conditions for Poisson's ratio as well as Hooke's law this equation we will get okay after that similarly you have to find out for this second plane okay so epsilon 2 which is equal to here only instead of 1 you have to write here sigma 2 upon e minus mu into sigma 3 upon e minus mu into sigma 1 upon e okay and after that last for epsilon 3 for particular plane 3 same equation instead of sigma 1 you write here sigma 3 sigma 1 and 2 is in with mu so from this you will get this equations okay this is not asked in examination how to derive whatever may be so just you have to remember this formula just you have to remember formula but I have explained here basic fundamental from which basic fundamental this formula comes okay please write down this if you have any doubt ask me I will explain once again if you have doubt otherwise please write down this if you have doubt
then correct
okay I will explain once again so this is a cube on that number of forces are applied p1 p2 p3 due to this p1 force stress will be generated and strain will be generated so here write down sigma 1 and epsilon 1 now we will move towards this p2 force due to this p2 force stress and strain have generated and this shows in on that plane 2 due to this p3 force stress 3 and strain 3 are generated and shown in this plane 3 now we have to check the effect of combined forces on that cube okay effect of combined forces on that cube so already we have considered stress in x direction which is equal to stress in y direction which is equal to stress in z direction that is epsilon 1 strain in one direction plus strain in second direction plus strain in third direction okay now we have to find out or we have to correlate the equation between stress Young's modulus and this mu okay so for that first epsilon 1 which is equal to sigma 1 upon e that is stress along one plane divided by Young's modulus minus mu into sigma 2 upon e minus mu into sigma 3 upon e आता बघा इथे तुम्हाला प्रश्न पडला असेल की फर्स्ट प्लेनला काय घेतलेला इथे बघा सिग्मा 1 अपॉन ई हे कशावरून घेतलं तर आपल्याकडे एक इक्वेशन आहे स्ट्रेस इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द स्ट्रेन ओके स्ट्रेस इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द strain so strain which is equal to stress upon Young's modulus by using this basic concept this equation comes here
मैडम आवाज इतना ही।
ओके नाउ मे ऑडिबल?
यस मैम।
हाँ ओके सो वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट स्ट्रेन। ओके वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट स्ट्रेन। आई विल क्लियर एंड वंस अगेन आई विल रिपीट। सो नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट स्ट्रेन। Already we have discussed the stress is directly proportional to the strain. Okay, so sigma which is equal to E into epsilon. Suppose you have to find out epsilon. So how to find out epsilon? Epsilon which is equal to stress upon Young's modulus. Okay, now here we have to find out strain along one plane. Okay, strain along one plane. So here epsilon 1 which is equal to. इक्वेशन काय मिळेल आपल्याला इथे एप्सिलॉन वन विच इज इक्वल टू सिग्मा वन अपॉन ई। ओके सो आय हॅव रिटन हियर सिग्मा वन अपॉन ई। नाऊ वी हॅव टू चेक ड्यू टू दिस पी टू फोर्स विच इफेक्ट इज वी हॅव टू चेक विच इफेक्ट इज क्रिएटेड हियर। ओके सो दिस पी टू फोर्स इज ऍक्ट ॲज अ ऍक्झियल फोर्स। दिस पी टू फोर्स इज ऍक्ट ॲज अ ऍक्झियल फोर्स अँड दिस पी वन फोर्स इज ऍक्ट ॲज अ lateral force. Okay, already one equation or one ratio you know that mu which is equal to lateral strain to the axial strain. Okay, lateral strain to the axial strain. So mu which is equal to lateral strain. Okay, mu which is equal to lateral strain. So lateral is epsilon 1, lateral is epsilon 1 divided by axial, axial that is epsilon 2. So axial is epsilon 2. Now I will this epsilon 2 multiply this mu. So minus mu into epsilon 2 which is equal to epsilon 1. Hey equation tar lakshat aali ithaparyant. Now we have to put the value of this epsilon 2. Aplyala kay karayche hai epsilon 2 chi value put karayche. Already one basic equation with you sigma sorry epsilon which is equal to stress upon Young's modulus. Suppose you have to find out for plane 2 at that time epsilon 2 which is equal to sigma 2 upon E. So this is the value for epsilon 2. Therefore epsilon 1 which is equal to minus mu into sigma 2 upon E. So this term is here. Okay, this term is here for this P2 effect. Now we have to check this P3 effect. You have to check this P3 effect. When you are going to check this P3 effect, at that time this P3 acts as a axial stress or axial force and this P1 will act as a lateral strain. So from that you will get minus mu into sigma 3 upon E. So similarly, you have to find out sigma 2. So sigma 2, which is sorry, epsilon 2, that is strain along second plane, which is equal to instead of sigma 1, you write here sigma 2 upon E minus remaining two terms, sigma 3 and sigma 1. When you are going to calculate for third plane, sigma 3 upon E minus mu into remaining two terms, that is sigma 1 and sigma 2. Now your doubt is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, please write down this and write down this last equation. This is not asked in examination, but this is for your knowledge. Please write down and let me know after your writing is over. So I will move towards next part.
Over, ma'am.
Okay. Now we will move towards next point. I will clear all drawings. Okay. Now we will see 1, 2, 3 example on this volumetric strain. Okay. For that, I will share my screen and then we will continue. Okay. Please write down volumetric strain for cube. Volumetric strain for cube. How to find out volumetric strain for cube? Okay. For that, I will draw figure simultaneously. You can also draw. सर पलीकडे चालू प्रॉब्लेम Okay, please draw this figure, then we will see how to derive.
Over, ma'am.
Okay, your drawing is over. Shall I start derivation?
Yes, ma'am.
We have to find out volumetric strain for this cube. Okay, so for this cube, dimensions are given here. Okay, this is width, this is depth, and this is length. So we have to find out volumetric strain. Now you tell me, volumetric strain is denoted by using epsilon V, which is equal to what is formula? Del V upon V, that is change in volume upon original volume. Okay, first we will find out original volume. Now you tell me how to find out original volume, V, which is equal to simply V into D into L. We will take multiplication of all dimensions. So V, which is equal to BDL. This is original volume. Now we have to find out change in volume. So how to find out this change in volume? By taking derivative. Okay, we will take partial derivative. So V, so derivative of this V is del V, which is equal to, now we will take derivative of this B. So derivative of this B is del V into this D as it is, this L is as it is, plus now we will take derivative of this D. So B we will take as it is, derivative of D into L as it is, plus now we will take derivative of this L. So B into D as it is into derivative of L. This is the change in volume. Now we will apply equation epsilon V, which is equal to del V upon V, which is equal to, now I will put values here. Okay. So del B into B into D into L plus B into del D into L plus B into D into del L, divided by original volume is B into D into L. Now we will separate this denominator. So del V upon V, which is equal to del B into D into L upon B D L plus B into del D into L upon B into D into L plus B into D into del L upon B into D into L. Now we will cancel common terms. This D, D get cancelled. This L, L get cancelled. Here this B, B get cancelled. This L, L get cancelled. Here this B, B get cancelled. This B, B get cancelled. This D and D get cancelled. So what is remaining? Del L upon, sorry, del V upon V, which is equal to, what is remaining for first point?
Del V upon V
plus in second del D upon D plus in third del L upon L. So del V upon V, nothing but epsilon V, which is equal to, this is epsilon V plus epsilon D plus epsilon L. So this is our volumetric strain for cube. Okay. Or simply you write down this del V upon V, which is equal to epsilon B plus epsilon D plus epsilon L. This is our volumetric strain for cube. If you have doubt, please ask me. If any step you have not understood, ask me, I will explain. Are you got doubt for Nalakai?
No, ma'am.
Okay, no doubt. Please write down this. After your drawing is over, let me know.
Or ma'am.
Okay. Then next we will see for cylindrical rod, how to find out volumetric strain for cylindrical rod. But only 3 minutes are remaining for ending this meeting. So I will end meeting. Please rejoin meeting by using same link. Okay.